You know what's funny? This wasn't even a JBL ad. It was an ad for Maxell. So, me starting my review of the L100 Classic here by using this reference is kind of dumb. But we do remember the L100 in this way because, well, look at it. It's one of the most iconic speakers ever made. But this wasn't a JBL ad. It was a Maxell ad. And honestly, the way Maxell sold the speaker through the ad and their sound really kind of sells the L100 Classic short. Yeah. This doesn't fit at all.
No.
No, this doesn't work at all. The L100s came out in 1970, and they are one of the most iconic loudspeakers ever made. Now, the L100s have not been in continuous production since 1970. They kind of phased out somewhere around the 80s. But, you know, everything that's old is new again. And in 2018, JBL, more specifically JBL Synthesis, decided to bring back the L100 in the L100 Classic. Now, I don't think that even the most astute eye could tell the difference between the original and the Classic. Are they the same speaker? No, they're not. While they may look the same, while they may even possess many of the same components and drivers, this is a new updated speaker for 2019. The reason I can say that is I actually owned a used pair of L100s from back in the day. I can tell you just based on my personal experience and memory, the L100 Classic is an entirely new animal. In a lot of ways, the L100 was a great rock and roll speaker, and it was maybe even like a PA speaker in consumer clothing. The L100 Classics, however, have all of that, but now have nuance, musicality, and dare I say, audiophile cred beyond just the fact that, you know, they're nostalgic. That is the biggest surprise that I had during my time here with the L100 Classics, is just how good they are and just how much more speaker they are despite not having tweeters made of beryllium and the woofers, both bass and mid-range, being composed of paper. That's right, there's no esoteric materials used anywhere in this loudspeaker whatsoever. And yet, with mundane materials and just good old-fashioned engineering, we are treated to, in my opinion, and what I found during my review here, one of the finer sounding loudspeakers on the market today. So what does it sound like? Well, this is an incredibly neutral speaker. And what I mean by that when I say neutral, because I know I've made a few videos where I refer to things as neutral, I don't like components that color the sound. For instance, you have a lead singer that you know, love, and are very familiar with. Maybe you've even had the good fortune of seeing them live. Well, you now have an oral memory of what that singer's voice sounds like, male or female. And if a speaker is not neutral, then a speaker is imparting a little coloration or is effectively changing the sound of that singer's voice. The JBL L100 Classics don't do that. They are neutral to the source material, and that is a good thing. I know a lot of people will talk about speakers being lively or dark or this. Those are all sonic characteristics, and those can be something that, based on your personal taste, you may want. But the JBL and Harman products in general tend to try and be as neutral as possible. And I think the reason for this is because JBL, being part of a larger Harman ecosystem, is concerned with keeping the signal coherent from recording to exhibition. So with these being neutral, what is there kind of to comment on? Because a neutral speaker should have no sound of its own. This is true, but a neutral speaker is also needs to be capable of reproducing all of the things contained within a recording. So this speaker is incredibly dynamic, incredibly capable of large crescendos and swings. It has amazing bass impact and speed. However, it doesn't have the deepest bass that I have encountered in my travels. And that's kind of surprising given the fact that the L100 Classic utilizes a 12-inch driver for its bass frequencies. And you would expect a 12-inch driver, especially a ported 12-inch driver, to be, well, a little bit richer in the bottom end. But for true full range performance, you're gonna wanna mate the L100 Classic to a subwoofer. The mid-range is neutral, articulate, textural, everything that you're going to be looking for and are going to want in a quality loudspeaker. The high frequencies, the tweeter is made of titanium. That's right, titanium. Remember when I said none of this was esoteric? This titanium tweeter puts some beryllium tweeters to shame, and I actually think that it rivals that of my old Bowers & Wilkins 800 Diamond series. The tweeter in this is not harsh at loud volumes. It's extremely airy and extended, and I am absolutely in love with the thing. And the best part too about the sonic signature of the speaker is if you want a little bit more, call it sparkle on the high end, or maybe you have a really live room and you want to tame that high frequency down a bit, there are high frequency and low frequency level controls. And these are a carryover from the original. For the purposes of my review, having experimented with them, I did leave the dials in their neutral position because I found that that's just simply where the speaker sounded best. But the thing about the L100 Classics that's really, really surprising is the fact that despite being a larger speaker, these disappear orally unlike any loudspeaker I think that I've ever encountered. The soundstage that I heard in my listening room, which is where we are right now, it broke free of the side walls and the back wall and the front wall, and it filled my space with sound. Now, it wasn't just throwing sound willy-nilly everywhere. It was all very well controlled, very neatly defined in three-dimensional space. Because of that, I could literally be listening to a recording and direct all of my attention to the left or right speaker and not be able to see it, you know, in my mind's eye. And this means that the dispersion characteristics of the L100 Classic are absolutely beyond reproach. And it has one of the finest center images I have ever been able to recreate in any listening room or environment that I've put together. Now, the JBL L100 Classics, like the originals, do sit on proprietary or, I guess, purpose-built stands. This keeps their profile low while seating them at a slight 45 or 30 degree upward rake. I think that this accounts for why they are such soundstage kings in terms of filling room with sound, because it does direct some of that sound upward. And when you're watching movies or listening to large scale musical ensembles or performances, it gives the soundstage not only lateral depth, but vertical height. And that is something incredibly infectious and an aspect of their performance that is surprising and something that not a lot of speakers do. A lot of floor standing speakers and even bookshelf speakers tend to direct the sound at you based on the height that they are standing. What else can I say about these speakers? Well, they play loud, and they can play loud so effortlessly. This is a loudspeaker that will reward you if you have a good power amp. Obviously, you know that I use the Crown XLS Drive Core 2s. But if you have a lot of power, this speaker will reward you. But unlike other modern speakers, especially modern speakers in its class, it does not require gobs and gobs of power. So let's just get to the elephant in the room. How much does all this awesomeness cost? Well, it costs $4,000 a pair. That's right, the JBL L100 Classics are $4,000 a pair. And before you click off this video or scroll down to leave me a negative comment, I want to put something in perspective for you. If you take $4,000 a pair and you adjust for inflation and you go back to 1970, believe it or not, these speakers in 2019 cost about the same as they did when they were released in 1970. And to be perfectly honest, I would rather have a speaker that has this heritage this vibe, this style, and its performance at $4,000 a pair than a lot of speakers claiming to be affordable or budget friendly that cost more than this that give you way, way less. Sorry, it's true. I don't consider the stands to be optional, although JBL does, which is why they charge you $300 a pair for the privilege of owning them. You need to have them. So if it were me and someone was asking, okay, how much does it really cost to put a system together around these speakers? Well, for starters, the speakers themselves with the stands are gonna be $4,300. Now, I powered them with my Crown amp, which I picked up at Guitar Center for like 200 bucks, new in the box. I have no problem recommending that amp, in which case then you need a preamp, a couple of source components, and you are ready to truly, truly rock and roll. So there you have it. That is my take on the JBL L100 Classic. And I do think that the L100 Classic is every bit the superior speaker when compared to the L100. In fact, I'm gonna go so far as to say that in 20 years' time, I think it's the Classic we're going to be talking about and not the original L100. And that's big praise because I love me some L100. But the L100 Classic, this thing's a beast. So that's it. That's the end of my review. These things are f***ing awesome. They're just awesome. I mean, you can comment down below and say you disagree with me, but I have them. I've heard them. And they are awesome. Of course we're gonna do it.